In this video, you will learn how to apply rule-based transformations and how to transform numbers and strings in Numeratics platform. Let's have a look. You have a table containing demographic data. For each person, you have their age, education, occupation, and so on. You notice that the native countries are written with a hyphen and want to remove it. You also want to round up people's age to the nearest 10. And finally, you want to create three categories of people: unemployed, employed part-time, and employed full-time, based on their number of weekly work hours. Let's start with the last task. You can perform the categorizing of people with the Rule Engine node. First, open its configuration window. On the left, find the column list, which shows all the available columns from the input data table. Right underneath, you have the flow variable list, which lists all the flow variables available to the node. In the middle, you can find the function panel, which contains the functions and logical operations to be used in the rule set. Note that you can filter functions by category. When a function is selected in the function panel, the description of its tasks and the mode of use is displayed. Finally, at the bottom, you have the expression panel, which is the core piece of this node. Here, you can define a set of rules to apply. Every rule consists of a condition and a consequence, and is applied to each row of a table. First, you want to define that people who work 0 hours per week are unemployed. The column to test is the hour per week, so double-click it to insert in the rule editor with the right syntax already populated. Now, you need to compare the column value to 0. Search the operator equal in the function list, and double-click it to insert it in the rule. Then write 0 after the equal sign. You have a condition, so now you need the consequence. The symbol here, made by an equal sign followed by a greater sign, is the symbol that introduces the consequence value. In this case, the consequence is the string value unemployed. Note quotation marks to define the string. Write the result in a new column, work status. The rows where hours per week is 0 get unemployed in this new column. What about the other cases? Define a new rule. If a person works more than 0 hours but less than 40, their status is part-time. A third rule states that if a person works 40 hours or more per week, their status is full-time. However, since this last rule should include all remaining input data rows, we can just introduce a default condition covering all remaining data as true. This keyword true means that this condition is always true. Since conditions in a rule engine are verified from top to bottom, placing true at the end of the rule system collects all the leftover data rows. The next transformation is numeric. You want to round up each person's age to the nearest 10. You can do this with the Math Formula node. As you can see, the configuration of this node has the same structure as the one of the Rule Engine node. The functions are of course different. Look for the function round and add it via the double click. This function takes two parameters. The first is the value that you want to round. In this case, the age column, which you can add by double clicking it in the column list. The second parameter is the precision. Write -1 to round the value to the closest 10. This time, replace the column age and convert the result to an integer type. As a last task, you want to change the values in the native country column by replacing hyphens with the space character. Perform this with the string manipulation node. You know the configuration window already. Look for the function replace. You can see that many variations of the function are possible. Choose the one with string column to work on, the old substring to replace, and the new substring to use as a replacement. Double-click the column native country in the column list panel. Add the substring to be replaced as hyphen, and the replacement substring as space character. Note again that strings must be enclosed in quotation marks. Replace the values in the native country column with the new values. In the output table, you can see that composite values in the native country column are now separated by a space and not by an hyphen. In this video, you have learned how to apply rule-based transformations with the Rule Engine node, how to transform numbers with the Math Formula node, and how to transform strings with the String Manipulation node.